Hello, my lovely Libras. Welcome to your July 2018 reading. This is a general reading for you, my lovely Libras. If you would like a private reading, personalized reading for you, follow the link below my website in the information box below. It will take you to my readings and you can see what type of readings I offer, prices and payment methods there as well. So that's for private readings. This is a reading for Libra Sun, Rising and Moon sign. Also, if you're a Libra Sun listening to this, also listen to your Rising sign and Moon sign for added depth, detail. Some months that will resonate more for you than your Sun sign will. So have a listen to that as well. So, having said that, thank you for subscribing, liking, and leaving comments on my page, on my YouTube. I really appreciate that. It's lovely to connect with you all. So, let's have a look at what's in store for you. I've created this spread already for you, and it's really interesting. Again, you know, Libra, you always get such powerful cards. You absolutely get such powerful cards. 2018 is certainly your year. You know, you've got two aces and you've got, you know, kings and queens and, you know, really strong, wonderful cards. And let's see what's ahead for you, what's in store for you. Your timing is always going to vary. It depends on what's going on in your birth chart as to the timing of all of this. So, you know, if it's not happening for you this month, it may happen next month. It may move along, you know, before or after the times that I'm saying here. This is general. So have a listen, see what resonates with you. So let's get started. First card that is sitting here is the Two of Swords. And to me, the Two of Swords is, of course, you know, balancing things out, making a decision. There's a choice, there's a decision for you, because it's the swords, it's mental, it's thought, it's the mind, it's thinking about a situation. Libra, you find yourself in this situation where, you know, Librans have a hard time making a decision, making a choice. Here is opportunity here to make a decision, make a choice, and it's you're finding it difficult. For some of you, I'm going to say that the decision is difficult because not all the facts are available to you. Not all the facts are there. Hence the blindfold across here, across the eyes, which is, to me, an indication that you're not seeing all the facts. They're not all given to you. There's something that's not sitting well with you, that isn't right, that you need to explore even further. Have, you know, dig through, see what you can uncover, see what comes up, see what people, you know, people are hiding from you, or you haven't collected all the information, which will make the decision a lot easier. But you're finding yourself in this position of having to make a choice, having to decide on a situation. For some of you, it's a situation to do with love. Some of you, it's a situation to do with work or with family. It's going to be different for different Librans because you're all in different stages, you're all in different places. But the underlying thing is that there is a choice and there is a decision. Some of you are just going to have a hard time making that decision and making that choice. Others of you are having a hard time because you don't have all the facts. Excuse me. So you need to get the facts, have them all there, have them in front of you so that you can make that choice and that decision. You know, what's crossing you here is there's a real balancing of the ledger of life, balancing of the books, not necessarily financial, but factual, balancing information, balancing life and what it's thrown at you, and what choices you're going to make, what direction you're going to head in, you know, where your life is going to lead you from this point on. There's a lot of thought here. There's a lot of thought, but because it's pentacles, it's earthed, it's grounded. So it's not airy-fairy and, you know, just making choices and changes for the sake of it. There's a lot of, it's solid. There's a lot of facts. It's grounded, it's earthed, and you really are processing what's going on here. For some others of you, I feel like it's to do with work. It's to do with making, if there's a decision and a choice that you're making with your work, then what it's saying is, you know, for some of you, I feel like, is there a promotion coming up? There's a promotion or a job that you've applied for, and there's two jobs that you don't know which one to take. You're balancing the sums. One offers more money than the other, but then there's transport, there's movement. You might have to move house. There's things that have to also be entered into, and you're processing all of that. For others of you, there's a promotion, and you know, there's this. Well, I feel like I'm thinking, you know, do I take this promotion? Is the money actually worth the extra responsibility? You know, weighing all of that. That's what I'm seeing here, that you're weighing all of that. For others of you, it's I've got to make these changes into my direction. I'm bringing new things into my life. How do I want to make this work? Do I want it? Don't I want it? How's it going to sit? How's it going to work? So that for all of you, there's this sort of processing, but practically you're being practical about it. You're really being practical about it, because what's being given to you, what's coming through for you on a subconscious, on an esoteric level, is new beginnings, new learning, development of new skills, being able to soar the heights and really see, you know, eagles fly quite high and they get this fabulous perspective of the ground and the terrain below. They can see the tiniest thing, the tiniest animal running for shelter. They can see all these things from their vantage point. And I feel like this is you with the information that you've collected, with the knowledge that you have. You have this far sight. You can really look at what it is, where you're heading, what you're wanting, what you want to achieve, and where you're moving to, and putting things in place that are going to help you get there. So there's this opportunity here for new doorways, new openings, new pathways to open for you, and be very, very successful. It's, you know, soaring the currents. I feel like this flight, this change, it's still going with the flow, so to speak. You're soaring the currents. Eagles don't fly, they glide through the currents, through the air pockets, and it's easy. So this change is easy. Allow it to be easy. Just let it flow through. Don't get too caught up in, you know, things that are really not going to matter in the end. But there's a lot of new things coming in for you. And you know that because it's in your subconscious, because this is what's going on with you in your subconscious, you know, you have a sense of excitement of what's coming, a sense of what's coming. There's not necessarily knowing what it is, but it's something new. It's something good. It's, you know, it's about, you're going to be experiencing in July a really strong sense of intuition, a strong sense of knowing what's hidden, knowing what's in store. This is the card of the divine feminine, but it can be for males or females. It's just this knowing, this illuminating, your inner intuition, your inner guidance system, your dream life. Messages are going to come through for you. You know, this is a very feminine energy. And it, you know, still can apply to men. You know, it still can apply to men, because we're all yin and yang. And it's about tapping into that more sensitive side if you're a man, if you're a male. Okay, but it's really, I want to say dancing by the light of the moon. This is what I'm hearing, dancing by the light of the moon, you know, that real peace and tranquility that comes with that, that sense of beauty, which Librans love so much, and that peace, which Librans love. They need the balance. Their scales need to be balanced. So they need to feel that balance as well. You know, what's come in from, what you've brought in from May and June is this knowing that you're wanting a new direction in some part of your life. knowing that there needs to be a new direction in some part of your life, and making plans towards that, making plans towards bringing that in, you know, with confidence. You know, this is the Page of Coins. It's a very earth sign, and bringing in those changes and knowing that it's done with confidence. It's done with a surety. You know, it's just, you know, things that have happened in the past have brought you to this point of knowing where you want to be, knowing what you want to achieve, knowing where you want to go. And then the universe steps in and is bringing all these things to you. And what that's going to lead to, you know, as July keeps moving through, you're just going to find this new sense of confidence, passion, drive. For some of you, it's a change within yourselves. For some of you, I want to say this can be someone that's coming into your life that can be male or female, Queen of Wands, male or female, and Sagittarius, Aries or Leo, all have those qualities. Someone that really sees something that needs to be done, something that needs to happen, and they're just going to make it happen. They take charge, they take control, they move it forward. If it's someone that's coming into your life, male or female, it's, well, they've seen you, this is what they want, they're going to go for it, they're going to impress you, they're going to have a relationship with you. They want you, and that's it. They're just going to make a beeline for you, and they're going to make it happen. They're going to take charge. That real sense of drive. For some of you, it's discovering that creative source within you. This rediscovering this passion, stirring this passion, this drive, this fire in your belly for this project or this new venture that you want to take on. So it's going to be different for different Librans, but it's either going to be part of what you're moving towards, or it's someone that's coming into your life that's going to be a significant other. They're going to play a significant role in your life, okay? And so what is it moving to? What's going to happen as a result of what we've just seen here? What's going to happen? Well, you've got the Fool. The Fool is the first card of the tarot. So we've come full circle and you're back at the beginning of the tarot deck. Doesn't mean you're back where you started, because life is a spiral. It's not a circle. Life is a spiral. And each time it comes full circle, you move to the next level. Comes full circle, you move to the next level. And this is what's happening here. You're at this pivotal point in the year, and it's about having the courage to step off the edge into this new these new opportunities, this new life, doing things differently, taking with you everything you've learned in the last year or 2 years, 3 years. Everything you've learned is a culmination of getting you here at this point. And I feel like it's going to be week three, these change, you're going to feel like it's time now to have the courage to bring these changes in, to bring these changes on. Take it on. Make these decisions. It's time to step off empty-handed into the void and realize you're not going to fall. You're just going to move into new opportunities, bring new things into your life, because what it's just fantastic. You know, what it's going to trigger is this new beginning, finding your passion, finding your creativity, finding what puts that fire in your belly. When you find your joy, you find your passion, you've found your purpose in this life. And this is what you've been given this opportunity to explore. So why would you waste it? Take the leap. Because it's going to lead you to these new beginnings. You know, take this wand and and step into the lion's den, into the dragon's den, step into the fire, really step into the passion of what you want to do. It's as if the everyday, the humdrum is no longer serving you. It's like, I've got to get off this treadmill. I need to bring in this newness. And when you feel, when you get to a point where you're fearing it, you're feeling, oh my goodness, what have I done? Just breathe through it, take a step back and view it from a different perspective. View what's going on. View these changes from a perspective of you and what you've always wanted, what you've wanted to achieve, and what is possible for you, rather than looking at it from a viewpoint of fear and I'm comfortable where I am. Why would I want to change? Step out of that and have a look at the possibilities. Don't forget to see things from a higher perspective, which is this card as well. Stepping back and looking at things from a higher perspective, looking at the whole picture, looking at where it's going to take you and what you're going to be able to achieve is going to be really important for you, because it's, the Nine of Cups is the wish card. Whatever it is you want, it's there for you. You've set the table, the proverbial table. What have you got on it? Put on it what you want. What you've always wanted, what are your dreams and aspirations, what have you wanted to achieve? Stay focused on that, because that's what's going to start coming in for you, and it's going to be quite prosperous for you. It's going to be, there's financial abundance, there's financial rewards, there's financial comfort, there's abundance in success, finances, comfort, happiness, romance, whatever that abundance is for you, it's just going to bring it in. It's just going to bring it in. So, work out, remember what you wanted, what you wanted to achieve. And this is the wish card. It's all possible for you at this point. So bring it all in and watch it unfold. And it will unfold. I'm not going to say to you it's going to unfold at the end of July. It will unfold as the year progresses, and we're going, August, September, October. It will just start to come to fruition and unfold for you in this wonderful journey. So I think that's absolutely fantastic for you this month. There's a lot of aces and a lot of major arcana cards, and a lot of the kings, queens, pages. Fantastic. I'm going to take a card from the Angels of Abundance for you to give you your summary of what's I've lost half the deck here. I'll put that back. What's in summary of this month? Here we go. What's fallen out? God is your source. God is your source, and that's your intuition. God is your source. I'll read that for you. Let's see what it says. Everything you need is supplied by the infinite source of God, universe, Sai Baba, Buddha, whatever it is for you. And your faith opens the doorway to receive, which is absolutely what all this is about. In God, there is no lack or limitation. Rather, there is plenty of abundance for all to share. So there is abundance there for you, and you need to grab it with both hands and really bring those changes in and have an expectation that that's just going to be there for you. So I hope this resonates for you. Hope it helps you through July. And I wish you many, many blessings, love and light.